Hello, and welcome back to Oxygen Not Included. So, today, let's see, we're doing pretty good on food. We could stand to do a little bit better, but I don't want to push it because it does cost a lot of resources to get those. And every little bit that we do more than what we absolutely need is just kind of wasting time to a point. So let's see. So I think we've got all of this set to harvest already. Good. So what I want to do is just dig over. I guess what we're going to do is put this here. And we're going to submit bioscan. And hopefully that will get done within, you know, a relatively short amount of time. Okay, it looks like we're downtime now, so we're going to sleep. Let's take a look at our vitals real quick. Well, most everything is actually pretty well balanced right now, so that's good. So, while we're getting in there, which I already know this is an upgrade room, judging on the shape of it. Sorry. Trying not to cough in your ear. Oh. Gotta get the music in. At least a little bit. It's a little quiet, but I don't know, the peaks get a little bit much. Get it way too much. And then it gets too quiet. And it gets too loud. I don't get it. Alright. We've already dug that out. I do kind of want to get the Leeswort here. I just need to dig over and then down. Probably not too hard, but probably not the best thing to focus on right at the start. Is that? Is that really all of this cold biome? That's kind of tragic. And it will have to do, what we're going to do is, probably a little risky. Let's see if we can get, dug out. We're going to dig up. We're going to try and channel all of this water into here. I don't know if it's going to be great for it, but we want to also build a pump in here. And I think after we clear these out, we're actually going to build an oxygen room in here. That way we get it built nice and quickly. And we're actually going to run two pipes in. One that is going to supply the air for our base, and the other, I'll kind of lay it off so they go out there and work on that. Luckily we have a water lock, so that's not too bad for the moment. It might be getting germs. No, doesn't seem to be. So, that's fine. Let's just go mop it. Not that. Not you. Now we've got 5 duplicates. I don't think that's bad for now, but I think we're going up to maybe 8 when we can get the oxygen for both the suits and the food up. Which, probably not going to do this. We might do the meal ice. Wait, are we already cooking meal ice? Look at that, I'm already on the ball. Honestly, I forgot about this one. I play this one a little bit more methodically. But my test branches, which I usually don't show, I think I might have shown one once. But just like, I have a test world that I play pretty vanilla, but I usually make a little bit, you know, bigger mistakes. Just, you know, to test certain limitations. Awesome. So we have a vacillator in here. Who do we do? Let's do Joshua. Now, the cool thing about getting one of these early is not only is it close to the base for when we can recharge it when we get into space, but the buff that this guy gives is just amazing. I mean, four of the, like, five or six are great. Alright, now I gotta complete. Oh, this is great. So, deeper diver's lungs. So he has half oxygen requirements, so that means he's going to be able to, you know, go longer without oxygen, which means he could do more, like, down in the carbon dioxide area, which we've actually kept relatively low on this map so far, which I'm actually kind of proud of. How do I want to do this? I'm going to need to put... Oh, I don't have that yet. We might want to go ahead and do it. We're definitely doing pretty good. That one. We only need the one research left anyways. And let's see. Does look like our water situation is clearing up. Yes, good. Hopefully it's enough that we can start clearing it out. I saw it back up last night. We'll see. Luckily they have a little bit of a storage. We don't have to worry about it too much. So, with all of them through, there's 2,000 grams. So, we'll see if this does it. If not, I can put another one there. I kind of wanted one of these guys in here, but now I don't really care since I already have the light set up. Really, just because, like, the the way I have it, like, the three-tiered room is basically how I do things every time now. Seems to do the trick. And I just swap it to left or right, depending on which one I want to put it on. I think we're doing awesome in those departments. We don't really need to get too deep just yet. It's nice to see that there's a lot of algae that we can use. But I do want to get these set up as quickly as possible. Let's go ahead and rummage in here. If we get a snazzy suit, we'll go ahead and wear it. But whoever we decide is going to end up working in here is going to need to, what am I trying to say? get a cool vest if we end up with one of those. Warm sweater. And then cool vest. So, we do need one person to wear it. I don't know who our builder is. Let's see. seems that Liam tends to do it. Liam is the best, whatever. So let's give it to him. And then, if we see people building, then we might swap it later. But research is doing great. One time I had it set up to where not two people were researching, but honestly it's really good that they're both getting the training in the learning stat. Because that will transfer really well, not only to learning the learning stat, but say that five times fast, but the how do I want to say it? That goes into learning all your other stats too. So how do we want to do this? What I think we should do is cut in boom, 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 like that, right? And then we dig all of, not that, like there, out. And then I'll use that one to dig up. And then we're not going to have enough to store all of it. Maybe we can dig out this way a little bit, have it run off. Might take some clever digging. I do want to kind of get back there and seal this. I also want to come in here and auto harvest these. So one thing that I want to get up and running as well down here is another power setup, which as we get everything set up will unify into one, you know, working power system for the whole base. Which what we'll probably do, now that I'm really thinking about it, is have like a main grid and have two wires run up each side, one connect in here, one connect a little higher up, have a transformer room, and then run everything in from there. Oh, the things we will do. Okay, so the thing that we need to build down here is this. I kind of want to put our micro musher down here as well. And then red room. Okay, so let's go ahead and deconstruct, I guess. Do I already have it set to where they can't eat that? They can't, but they don't have any. So where do we want to set up power? It would be really funny just to set up a really bad mox system in here where our oxygen is. So let's see. I'm actually going to do it. Okay, so heavy. Manual. And these don't really use too much in the way of power. So that should be plenty. And then if I want to do anything else, I might run extra power off of that. I really think that if we're going to do both the game thing, station, whatever, the like the console thing, or the like like all the different things, we actually need to put each on a separate wire into the building. So we might need... we might be able to do a couple transformers on one heavy watt input, and then split multiple up per corner. That would be interesting. Do that for each of the power rooms. Might take up a little extra area, but... it would be a nice way to stick it out of the way and try and keep the temperature down inside the base. Like, even, like, right here above where the exit is would be good. Here comes the question. I do want to put my suits up here, Atmasuits. So what I'm probably going to do is just dig a tunnel straight down, and then come over this way. I can reconnect with all this, and I can, you know, close that off. And, well, probably just make it to where they can't, you know, walk through it, like put a mesh tile there. It'd be interesting. That way we can keep the carbon dioxide moving out. That's why I left this one a carbon dioxide lock. I think it's actually pretty smart. Of course, I'm not the one who discovered all those, so... definitely credit to them. Just glad we can use it. So let's see... did we happen to get... yeah, we did get all that dug out. So let's take... okay. So I want to cancel that. So... okay, that looks good. And then I think I will dig that, and then I'll let it down that way. Here, let's dig this a little higher so I can get through, and then I want to cancel that one. That way it doesn't run over. Even though I just dug that, but whatever. Either way, we're digging out this area in here. We're going to get rid of the slime. Where am I putting the slime? Right there. Okay. So we aren't getting the carbon dioxide transfer through. But I guess that's good now, the way I'm doing this. Oh, their systems aren't doing well. I think we're doing fine. Let's not worry about it too much. So one thing I wanted to check on. Okay, so proximity I want to turn on. And what that will do is tend to get things in an area completed at a much more rapid pace. Yeah, see, already they've started doing all of this stuff in this area. I think As long as we do this sparingly, like we get all this done and then we breach this and don't touch it, that at least should fill this. I kind of don't want to get into that one yet. But that will be the basis for our oxygen. And I'm going to go a little bit longer this episode as well. Just because I do want to get caught up. And honestly, this one is the first one I'm getting oxygen up this quickly. So, it's kind of nice. One thing that I'm going to set up in here is going to be a like a cooling loop. I've got to be careful because I don't want to disrupt any of this. I might just do a small one. And then basically I want to put a, I've done it before, like a temperature gauge to where I can set a certain temperature that it would stop the gas at. So let's see. Okay, so we can get the exosuit. Or at least exosuit forge. I want to get the oxygen set up before we do that, though. And I think I have a master idea for how to set up our oxygen channels. I'm going to set up one way for the base itself, and it's going to be, do I want to set that at a certain temperature? No, that's the one I want to temperaturize. And then if that one's full, I'm going to have it go off to the exosuits, which are going to be located here. No, I'm not making sense, but I'm getting the vision for how this is going to go. And it will definitely help the process along, I think. This update definitely feels like it's moving a little slower, like progress-wise, but I also believe that they reduced the height of the map as well. So I think we still have to dig up as high to get to the top, but we don't have to dig as low to get to petroleum. Or gasoline, whatever. Oil. Oh yeah, we need to take care of the power in here. No, we have power. Okay, so we want to... Can we do this yet? Forever. And then, so this uses sleet wheat and bristleberry. Wait, how much do we have? I thought we had the bristleberry. So what we'll do instead is you forever. That will be a good boost. And hopefully we can actually transition into better food really early. So that we can really start focusing on other things other than, keeping people in jobs that's not going to kill them, especially as we come into these darker, dirtier, grosser areas. It's a germage, like, it's a lot of germage. But our immune system seemed to be doing just fine. Pretty sure that I put this as a normal game, but, you know, I'm not going to argue if they're going to give it to me. Okay, so it looks like we've caught up on our bristleberry, actually. So, let's see. Okay, so it does look like we can make at least two. And let's actually look at our priorities before we do anything else. We actually want to discourage these guys from cooking because that will be a lot better. Tidying's okay. Let's actually turn these guys down. Actually, let's turn them off. Don't do it, period. I don't want it. Just Catalina for whatever reason. We're actually doing terrible at getting all of our jobs. Once we get our oxygen up, that will definitely be a good thing to do, I guess. We have a lot of operators. So that's actually getting done. That's getting done brilliantly. Let's actually cancel this. Cancel that. I don't want you to do it. And then as we finish that, we'll be good. Ooh, we actually caught most of them right as they were getting through with their jobs. Let's go ahead and send you to a level 8. I think as they start eating the better food, they're going to spike up even higher. One thing that I haven't checked on. Yeah, it's still a great home. Good. I didn't expect it to change, but sometimes things happen. You never know. Actually happy with the progress of this colony. Okay, we should have the other. Nope, just Lindsay. Do we send you as miner too? Yeah, you like it. I don't mind. Oh, she's literally dropping what she's doing. Go do it. Okay. Well, I'm actually going to call this downtime as a good time to wrap it up for this episode. Give Catalina a courier. That is wonderful. I love couriers. It makes things a lot easier in the base. But thank you for watching. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe below to see more of this wonderful game. There's more art coming. Lots of cool arc stuff. Oh, way too much good arc stuff coming. It's a little ridiculous, but we'll have some fun with it. Alright, thank you. Bye-bye.